What's up, guys? I'm Dustin here with Chase and Tail HD. Yesterday, we went out into the Gulf, had a lot of action. Today, what I'm planning to show you is how to clean a flounder. If you already know how to, please drop a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If y'all have any tips, leave it in the comments and let me know. Maybe you can teach me something new today, and let's get to cleaning. Alrighty guys, so this is the flounder we caught. Nothing huge. It's really thick though. It's got a lot of meat on it. Really a cool fish to catch, I think. It's probably one of my favorite fish to clean just because of the fact how different it really is to clean it. We'll just, without further ado, we will jump right into how to clean these fish. So, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to start it off like any regular fish. You know, you're going to cut down. You know, start above the head because you're missing a lot of meat if you don't. You got to cut in there. Alrighty, so once you have that, once you cut like that, you're going to cut a line right around. You're going to want to make sure you're getting all this meat up here, ton of meat right up in here. You're going to make sure you get all the way down to that backbone. Now, as you can see, and on the back you can really tell, and I'll show you all in a minute, there's this indention right down the middle of his back. Okay, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to take your knife, and you're going to want to follow that indention right down the center, all the way to the tail. So just like that, it's going to look just like that. And you will have a cut up front and a cut down the middle. So once you do that, you're going to want to come in here and you're going to want to try and line that spine and those the bones down there. I don't know exactly what those bones are called for the ones on the bottom. But you're just going to want to line them. Just take it really easy. You don't want to cut too deep and cut into the meat on the other side. So you just want to be gentle with it. Constantly apply pressure to the back while you're pulling the meat up, while you're trying to cut it. So just pull it up, give it a little bit of pressure. Really not that hard. Once you get started, it gets a little easier as you cut. Once you can get your knife a little flatter, so the deeper you get, the easier it gets. I just really think these are really neat fish to clean. Ouch. Probably easily my favorite. I've cleaned so many redfish now. I don't even enjoy the cleaning part, just the catching and the eating. All right, so now, as you can see, I'm getting to the nitty-gritty of it. Got just about all the meat, and I'm starting to hit his fins back here. None of that's really good meat up here, and I'll show you exactly what I'm talking about here momentarily. What I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna go ahead, try cutting it, ride it down, right down these lines. Bone. Let me go this way. Backtrack. I'm just gonna cut down just like this, right down to the tail. Some people will cut it all the way off for grilling purposes. I think I'm just gonna, I'm just gonna fillet it like I usually do on my other fish. Once you get this fillet off like this, it's pretty much no different than any other fish. You just wanna lay it flat and kind of. Take it easy. You don't want to cut the skin, but you don't want to leave no meat on the skin either. So just really, there ain't no. The faster you try to do it, easily, the more meat you'll miss. The more you'll mess up. If you cut through the skin, you run the risk of losing meat, some good meat. All right. So when I was saying that there's going to be a part of it that you're not going to want, and that's going to be this stuff right here. That stuff's no good. You don't want to eat it. But that's really solid fillet. It's really thick, really white meat. Extremely, extremely good if you've never had flounder. That's really just really good stuff. Just, you know, you can get creative. You can YouTube other videos. That's where I learned, and I learned from friends and people that I've camped with, and really just got to get out there and learn. And once you figure it out, you know, you can put your own little twist and tricks to it. But we're going to get the rest of this fish cleaned. Just like that, nothing but carcass, almost can see through. You can use it for crab bait if you're all about wanting to recycle. I'm just gonna throw it out into the water, let the bird have it. He's gonna enjoy that one for dinner, guys. Look at that. Ain't waste no time on that part. That's funny. Alrighty, guys, well, I try to do videos every week. Sometimes I miss out on my mark, but I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch y'all later.